Hello and welcome back to the tutorial series on TensorFlow using Python. In the previous videos, we learned what a tensor is and we installed TensorFlow in our systems. In this video, we will be learning about graph and session. So before we start coding, let us import TensorFlow. We'll do it by using import TensorFlow as tf. We have successfully imported TensorFlow. Now let us create a graph. What is a graph? Graph is basically a piece of code that represents computations. Any computations like A plus B, matrix multiplication, or just multiplication, or any sort of script in Python that we code in a TensorFlow is called as a graph. So let us write a simple small graph. Let's load two values. A, let's load 20 and let's take B equals 13. Now let's create a graph. So I want to calculate the addition. I'll load it in C. I want to add A and B. So in TensorFlow, we do not write C is equals to A plus B. There is a different method to add two values in TensorFlow. So we can write tf.add a comma b. This is how you add two values in TensorFlow, and you can even name this operation. I'll name it as add. So this small piece of code is a graph. So this is a computation where we add a and b. So let us expand this graph a bit. I will try to get multiplication. I'll like to show you multiplication as well. C is equal to tf. It is, as I said, it is different than normal Python multiplication where we use the star symbol. Here we use a different method, multiply, and I want to multiply. Let's multiply C and A. And I'll name it as, multiply. Now let's expand it a bit more, and this time I'll show you the division operation. A is equal to tf dot true div, and I'll be dividing d by a, and I'll name it as div. So this was, I expanded this graph a bit, and this small piece of code is a graph. Although this is not that complicated, but when you code neural networks, then the graph will be much larger. So now let's execute this part of code to get the value of e. So I'll print the value of e and I will run this code. As you can see, you can do the math here, but as you can see, the output is not as we expected. It is giving some weird output and I'm sure the output will not be zero. So why did the error arise? This is not an error, but why did we not get the expected output? This is because a graph is basically like a function in Python. It just initializes the values, but it does not execute the code. So in order to execute the code, we need to create a session. So session is where this part of code gets executed. So let's create a session. Let's name it as sess. tf.session. So this area we created a session. Now we will have to run this session, and now we'll have to run this operation in the session in order to get the proper output. sess.run, and I'll run e, and I even want to print this out, so I'll write a print right here, and I'll run this piece of code to get the output. So as you can see, you can do the math here, but I got a proper output as 33. You can do the math as compared to the previous one where we did not get a particular integer or a float value according to the computation. So in order to whenever you create a session, you even need to close it. So sess.close. So whenever you create a session this way, you need to close the session. So this is how the session is where the graph gets executed. So one of the biggest advantages of this sort of flow of code is that the session does not run the parts of code that do not need execution. For example, I'll write another part, f is equal to tf dot subtract a comma b. So I have written another operation in the graph. So when I try to run this part of code, this particular session, which is e, does not need the value of f. As you can see here, it takes the value d, it takes the value a, and it takes the value c, but there is no sign of f when you execute or run the part e, which is the division part. So it just initializes the subtract operation, but it does not actually run it. So this helps in proper management of computational power, and it helps in improving the speed of the code. So there's another method to write session. If you know, there's a tendency to for people to forget writing the session.close. So there's another method. I'll show you that we can do it with operation with tf.session as sess, and I will print this out, sess dot run e. So I'll run this code and I'll get an output as 33. So here you do not need to close the session, it automatically closes the session once the part is executed. So as you can see, we got the same output as 33. So this was a basic example of graph. We created a graph and we executed the graph using a session. So this in the next video, in the upcoming videos, we will learn about variables, constants and placeholders. So in case if you like the video, please click on the like button and subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.